弟兄们
好，谢谢。
Father, as we open your word now, we pray again, would you open our hearts?
天父上帝，当我们打开你的圣经的时候，求你同时打开我们的心灵。
As we allow your word into our hearts, it works very powerfully.
这样的话，我们才能够让你的话语在我们的心中大有能力的运行。
You are able to create new life.
你有能力来创造一个新的生命。
You create your life in us.
你在我们心中创造你的生命。
You restore our lives where they were broken.
你修复我们那破碎的生命。
You make us whole and new.
你使我们得到得以整全。
And you use our lives for your glory.
你使用你的生命为了你的荣耀。
And you prepare our lives to be with you in glory.
你预备我们的生命，便将来可以与你在永恒中。
So Father, we humbly ask that you would speak to us now.
天父上帝，我们在这里谦卑地祈求你，此时就与我们同在。
Use Sylvia and myself as your servant.
使用我与 Sylvia 做你的使
者。Pray these things in Jesus' name.
我们以耶稣基督的名祷告。
Amen.
Well, this final chapter of Hebrews lists the components and the character.Of what we need to live the miracle that is the life we have in God.
希伯来书最后一章罗列出来我们所需要活出神迹人生的一些要素和品质。
God has given us the gift of life.
神已经赐给我们生命这样一样礼物。
New life.
新的生命。
Born again life.
重生的生命。
The miracle life which God gives us as we follow Jesus.
这样一种神迹般的生命，神赐给我们，为的是要我们来跟随耶稣。
And the writer of Hebrews lists a number of distinctives and qualities found in this new life in Christ.
希伯来书的作者在这一章里面所罗列出来一些我们这样一个富有动力的基督徒的生命里面要活出怎样的特质和品格。
And there's lots of them, but we're going to look at seven briefly.
有很多的这样的品质和特质，但是我们今天只能看七项。
Number one，
第一点
，Keep on loving each other as brothers。
你们务要长存弟兄相爱的心。
We can never stop working at our relationships within the church family。
在教会这个大家庭里面，我们永远不可能停止来经营彼此之间的人际关系。
We can work at them as we work with God。
我们彼此建立关系，就像我们与神建立关系一样。
This love for each other made the early church very attractive.
这种彼此相爱的心，使当年的早期教会非常的吸引人。
Crowds came to witness this miracle of people being together and loving one another.
当时的人成群结队的来见证早期教会这种彼此相爱的这种现象。
We're God's family.
我们是神的家庭。
And this fact.Is the foundation of all we do as His church.
这一点就是我们作为他的教会的一个基石。
Now Hebrews gives some examples of how loving each other works.
希伯来书里面给了我们一些具体的榜样，告诉我们如何具体的彼此相爱。
He writes, "Show hospitality to strangers."
希伯来书的作者写道，用爱心接待客。
This is welcoming those that we don't know.
就是欢迎那些我们所不认识的人。
And the Bible says maybe it's an angel.
圣经说，也许这些陌生人就是天使。
Hands up, all those are angels.
在座的各位有没有？
这是 angels.
还不认识，可能就是、yeah. 你们就是我们的天使，请你举举手。
But basically, when there's a blessing, when we bless others and we look after and care for others that we don't know.
当我们去爱用爱心接待客旅、接待陌生人的时候，神会赐给我们祝福。
Some churches, and we try it in the morning, we have a 5-minute rule where for 5 minutes after the service, you're not allowed to talk to anyone you know.
有些教会有一个规矩，就是五分钟的规矩。我们教会上午的英文堂也实践过。也就是说，在聚会结束之后的五分钟之内，你不可以与认识的人说话，你只能与不认识的人。
But you can't sit quietly and say nothing. You've got to talk to someone you don't know.
但你也不可能坐在那里跟谁都不说话。你必须要与一位你还没有见过的人交谈。
And the second thing there in Hebrews, remember those in prison.
第二点 点，希伯来书的作者说道，要纪念被捆绑。
Anybody here in prison?
有没有被捆绑、被坐监的？
I just doesn't fear you. Oh, sure. What are you doing in prison?
牧牧师在监狱里做的什么呢？
He's been a bad boy this week. There are Christians today who are in prison because they follow Jesus.
今天有很多基督徒，因为他们的信仰，因为跟随耶稣而坐监。
Can you imagine some of the prisons there are around the world? Horrible places. They're in prison because they follow Jesus. They're in prison because the governments hate Christianity. They're in prison because there are groups of people who persecute Christians.
今天在世界各地都有很可怕的监狱里面关很多的基督徒，他们因为跟随耶稣，因为当地的政府，迫害基督徒，所以他们才会，下到监狱里面。
Every 5 minutes, a Christian is killed.
每隔五分钟，平均每隔五分钟就有一位基督徒被杀。
As part of the persecution.
这是今天我们所要面对的迫害。
So we're to pray for these people. They're our brothers and sisters. We don't know them, but they're our brothers and sisters, and we pray for those who are being persecuted.
所以我们要为那些被捆绑的人祷告。他们虽然我不认识他们，他们也是我们的弟兄姐妹，所以我们。
Number two,
第二个,
marriage should be honored by all.
婚姻人人都当尊重。
Christian marriages are a wonderful example of Christianity.
基督徒的婚姻是基督教信仰一个奇妙的榜样。
Our marriages should be different to the world.
我们的婚姻应该是与这个世界上的婚姻不一样。
In our marriages, we can love and be together in a way that the world envies.
在婚姻中，我们作为基督徒所拥有的那种爱与合一，是应当让整个世界都羡慕嫉妒恨。
Christian marriage is based on a love that is giving, whereas many marriages are based on giving.
基督徒的婚姻是建立在一种付出的爱，而很多的婚姻是建立在索取的基础上。
Many marriages fail because the expectations of what my wife is going to give me.Or my husband is going to give me.
很多的婚姻失败了，是因为他们不能够得到他们预期他的妻子应该给出的，或者预期他的丈夫应该付的。
But then we find out our wife is not God.
然后我们发现我们的太太并不是上帝。
And our husband is definitely not God.
我们的丈夫也绝对不是上帝。
And they fail to meet our full need.
他们也不可能，因为他们不是神，所以不可能完全满足我们。
But in a Christian marriage, we learn to give to each other.
但是在基督徒的婚姻里面，我们要学习彼此付出。
I'm going to give an illustration. I haven't told Sylvia, so if the translation doesn't go well, just smile. But an illustration of heaven and hell.
我们现在需要讲一个例子，举一个例子，就是天堂和地狱的比喻。
In heaven, everyone is given chopsticks that are that long.
在天堂上，每一个人都给了一根，就是很长很长的筷子。
那老公呢？
夸张
了。But too short.
我的手臂没有那么的长，就这样。
In heaven, did I say hell first?
Heaven.
In hell, everyone is given chopsticks that long.
在地狱里面，每个人也拿了一根很长的筷子。
But in hell, everyone is selfish.
但是在地狱里面，每个人都非常自私。
And in heaven, everyone is giving.
但在天堂上，每个人都愿意付出。
So in heaven, with my chopsticks, I pick up a piece of food and I feed Jack.
在天堂上，我用那双很长很长的筷子接了一个块食物，就供他来喂贾牧师。
Sorry, John. But in hell, we're all so selfish. We're trying to get it into our own mouth, and the chopstick is too long.
但是在地狱里面呢，我们每个人都想自己吃，所以用很长的筷子喂自己，但是很困难。
Christians are not to practice adultery or sexual immorality, but remain faithful to each other.
基督徒不可以苟合，不可以犯奸淫，而是应该彼此忠诚。
Now adultery is sexual relationship with someone else's wife or husband.
奸淫乃是与其他人的配偶所发生的一种性关系。
We all know that's wrong.
我们都知道那是不对的。
Yeah. Sexual immorality, the Greek word for that is pornos. Does anyone know an English word that is similar to that? Let the translation first.
你说 sexual immorality 就是不道德的性行为的，它是源自于一个希腊，希腊一个 pornos。
Right. What English word is like that Greek word pornos?
有哪一个英文词是这个怎么接近？
Pornography, exactly, comes from that word. Pornos, the old English word for that is fornication.
色情的一个比较老的一个英语词就是 fornication, 就是通奸乱伦。
That's right. And that means any sort of sexual activity outside of marriage.
但是泛指所有在婚姻以外的性行为。
Now, many churches today have said it's okay, it doesn't matter. How many think those churches are wrong? All very good. Because God is still God, is still God, is still God, is still God. And His word is still true, is still true, is still true, is still true. And God knows what is good for us. God knows what's right for us. God knows what protects us. God knows what helps us and keeps us safe.
上帝知道什么是对我们好的，什么是对我们是对的，什么能够保护我们，什么能够使我们安全。
And sadly, in my job, I have to help a number, particularly men who struggle with pornography.
但是我作为一位主任牧师，经常要去帮助一些受色情所困扰的男性。
And they get images in their minds and in their hearts, which make it very hard to have an honest relationship with a wife, because a wife never looks like the center of a magazine.
他们的心灵和头脑都已经被那些色情报纸上的形象所污染，所以他们无法和他的妻子建立一个正式的关系。
Good marriages don't just happen.
幸福的婚姻不是从石头里蹦出来。
God gives us the love, and He leaves it to us to practice the love.
神赐给我们爱，但是呢，需要我们自己去实践和操练。
I can have love in my heart for Penny.
我可以在心里充满对 Penny 的师母的爱。
But I have to use that love and go and love her.
那我需要运用这个爱，然后去用爱把它表现出来。
And so I do things for her. I tell her every day.Several times a day, I will say, because she forgets, she's a little thing. I tell her, I love you.
所以呢，我要在运用这个爱的过程中为她做很多事情，每天甚至一天里面说几次我爱你。
And she says, thank you.
然后她说谢谢。
And I say, you're welcome.
不用谢。
And she says, it's a pleasure.
我很高兴。
True.
这是真的。
Alright, number three. Keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have. The need for money can test the truth of our love for God. We're called to be content with all that God gives us.
我们文章乃是要以神所赐给我们的为满足。
Otherwise, we won't be tempted to be saying God is not good. God is not a good provider.
我们若是不满足的话，便是在埋怨神不够照顾。
When we focus our lives on getting money, we lose sight with what we really have.
如果我们生命的中心是一直盯着怎么样去赚更多的钱，那我们就会忘记看到说我们实际已经拥有的那些。
Money can be seen as that which makes us happy rather than God.
在这种情况下，钱就变成那个使我们快乐的因素，而不是神本身。
So how can we be content with what we have?
那我们怎么样以自己所有的为主呢？
Well, the writer of Hebrews says, God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you.
希伯来书的作者这样说，因为主曾说，我总不撇下你，也不丢弃你。
It's a wonderful promise.
这是个奇妙的应许。
God is always with us, and will never let us down.
神永远与我们同在，他从来不会使我们失望。
Sometimes he lets us go through things that seem really hard.
有时候他会让我们经历一些苦难。
But we look back and we see they were the best thing for us to go through.
但当我们回过头来看的话，那些是我们生命中可能最好的。
So we're called to take this truth to heart and live constantly in the reality of God's goodness.
神呼召我们要把这个真理深藏在心里，这样才能在这一事实中坦然无惧的生活。
And so verse 6, so we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper.
所以我们可以放胆说，主是帮助我。
What more do you need?
我们还需要什么呢？
You've got God the Creator helping you.
因为神作为创造主已经在帮助我。
I will not be afraid, the writer says.
希伯来书的作者说，我必不惧怕。
We live with God, no matter what anyone else says.
我们是为主而活，不需要无所谓别人说什么。
I remember when I was at school, I was a bit smaller than I am now.
我记得我在学校的时候，身材比较小。
And I used to, when a bully came, I used to say, "My dad's a policeman."
当有一个人要过来霸凌我的时候，我就对他再说，你的爸爸是警察。
And bullies are usually a bit thick.
通常那些霸凌别人的孩子的那些人呢，脑子不是很快。
And they believe me.
他就相信了。
My father's not a policeman, but my father is God.
我的地上的父亲并不是个警察，但是我的天父是上帝。
So I will not be afraid.
所以我并不惧怕。
And so the writer says, "What can man do to me?"
希伯来书的作者继续说，人能把我怎么样呢？
Well, they can hurt us.
别人可以伤害我们吗？
But at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter because I'm God's, and I'm going to go and be with Him, and He loves me, and He's looking after me.
即便别人伤害了我们也没有关系，因为到世界的末日，我是与神同在。
C.S. Lewis, as it says on the screen, he who has God and everything has no more than he who has God alone.
C.S. 鲁伊斯，一位基督教文学家说，那拥有神和其他一切的人，并不比用单单拥有神的人拥有更多。
In verse 8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today.And forever.
第八节说到，耶稣基督昨日、今日，一直到永远是一样的。
Jesus and His words, promises, His character, and His power never change.
耶稣与他的话语、他的应许、他的属性、他的能力永远不变。
We can be content with God because we have the same Jesus with us that the disciples had with Him.
我们应当以神为满足，因为我们已经拥有了耶稣。而那位耶稣就是那些门徒所拥有的那位。
And now he's the risen Lord Jesus.
他是这位复活的主耶稣。
He loves us.
他爱我。
He walks with us and leads us.
他与我们同行，也引导我们。
He has all the power of God.
他有神所有的所有的能力。
And he sent his Spirit to be with us and to be in us.
他差遣他的圣灵与我们同在，也在我们里面。
And for his Spirit to come upon us and give us his power.And mightily enable us to live this new life.
他差遣圣灵降临在我们身上，赐给我们能力，大有能力的帮助我们活出神迹般的一生。
Number four.
第四点。
Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise.
我们应当靠着耶稣，常常以颂赞为祭献给神。
A Christian is one that's so content with God and appreciative that they praise God a lot.
基督徒应该是这样的，他们以神为满足，因此常常颂赞不尽。
Continually.
就是要经常这样做。
In our minds, you keep seeing things and you go, "Wow, that was good, God. Oh, thank you." An answer to prayer or something you sensed or some way that He saved you or helped you, and you praise God and you worship.
在我们的心里、嘴上，也常常看到神在我们生命中所做的，常常献祭给他，常常感谢他。
Several hundred years ago, a church council agreed that the most important thing that we do as Christians is to glorify God and enjoy Him forever.
100年以前，有一个教会会议得出一个结论：作为基督徒，一个最重要的事情就是永远荣耀神，并。
We have so many reasons to praise God.
我们有那么多的理由可以来感谢神。
Not least his love and his goodness.
不仅仅是因为着他的爱，他的良善。
And his salvation.
以及他给我们的救恩。
But it's up to us.
但是否颂赞神，完全取决于我们。
God can be great and good and generous and everything, and we can just.
神可以很伟大，很慷慨，很有恩典，但是我们可以还是不颂赞。
We've got to make the effort. It's going to let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise. It takes effort.
我们要努力，我们要下有这样的意愿，常常以颂赞为祭献。
As in my marriage, it can be. Oh, I love him.
就好像在我的婚姻里面，我也可以很冷淡的说，我也爱他。
And as most men, I can say, I told you when we got married, and I will let you know if the situation changes.
因为大部分的男生都会对太太说，我们结婚的时候我已经跟你说过我爱你。如果这件事情发生变化的时候，我会再跟你说。
But that's not a sacrifice of praise.
但是这不是以颂赞为祭。
So as a male, Tara.But many times a day, I have to sacrifice and say, "I love you, Benny."
作为一个男生，天天在那里送赞我的太太，非常的困难。但是我也要做这个牺牲，说我爱你 ，Benny。
God is so much more wonderful, so much greater, so much full of love, so much better to me. How can I not say to God many, many times with all my effort and strength and without reserve?I love you, God.
神当然比我的太太更伟大，更值得颂赞，所以我要用我的全心全力来颂赞他。
And even when I don't feel it, I sacrifice and say, "I love you, God." Even when things are going hard.
即便有的时候我的感觉并不想说赞美的话，但是我要对自己说，我要付出这个代价，用牺牲的心对神说，我要赞美。
We understand?
Yes.
理解吗？
Okay. Number five.
第五点。
And do not forget to do good and to share with others, for such sacrifices God is pleased.
不可忘记行善和捐书的事，因为这样的祭是神所喜悦的。
This is what we do as Christians.
这是我们基督徒应做的事。
When we do good to others and help them, God is pleased.
当我们对别人行善的时候，神是喜悦的。
As we're doing good to others, we are actually doing good to God.
当我们在人身上行善的时候，就是在神身上行善。
And Jesus says in the parable, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me."
耶稣在马太福音中曾说过，我实在告诉你们，这些事你们既做在这弟兄中一个最小身上，就是做在我身上。
So when you take your elderly next-door neighbor who's not very well some Chinese yummy food, you are actually taking it and giving it to God.
当比如说，当你把一些很美味的中餐送给隔壁的一位老太太或老先生的时候，你其实是把它送给神，而不仅仅是送给你的邻居。
I think God likes Chinese food. Number six.
第六点。
Obey your leaders and submit to their authority.
你们要顺从那些领导你们的，且要顺。
Now God has appointed those who are called to keep a watch over you.
神设立了那些为我们的灵魂时刻警醒的。
And they must give an account.For how they do that.
而且他们将来要交账。
I'm not sure why Yong Jun's in prison over there.
知道为什么永俊下监了。
But it's a serious work to be a pastor or an elder in this church.
但是在这个教会里面，无论是做长老也好，做牧师也好，是一件非常严肃的事情。
It's a bit scary.
有的时候也是蛮吓人的。
Because one day.Yamashua is going to have to stand before God, and he is going to have to give an account for how he has looked after you.
因为有一天，贾牧师会站在神的面前，向神交账，说他是如何牧养这个教会。
Now, if you ignore him, that's your problem.
如果你不理他的话，这是你的问题。
But he must be faithful to God to serve you and serve him well.
他必须要忠心耿耿侍奉神，也侍奉这个教会。
Now most leaders I know love the Lord and love this church.
我所认识的绝大部分教会领袖。
And they're faithful in prayer and in service.
他们爱主也爱他的教会，他们在祷告和侍奉上也非常忠心。
And if you see that your leaders are faithful to God and faithful to His Word, then you can trust them and follow their lead obediently.
若你们看到你们的教会领袖是对神忠心，也对他的话语非常忠心的话，这个时候你应该信靠他们，也顺服他们的领导。
The Bible is saying here, work with them that their work or their ministry.Would be a joy and not a burden.
希伯来书的作者写道：“当你们与他们同工的时候，他们的工作就是一种喜乐，而不是一种负担。若是那样，若是一种负担的话，就一种无益。”
In fact, the original Greek word means groaning.
在这里，希腊文的原文对于负担这个词是呻吟。
So if you see your pastors groaning.
当你们看到你的牧师在呻吟的时候。
You know, someone's not looking after them.
你就知道有一些人没有好好照顾他。
And someone's giving them a hard time.
有些人给他们一些不太好的时间，日子不太好过。
And I'll come and get them.
然后就回来修理他们。
What the Bible says, it is of no benefit to you if you do not treat your pastors and leaders and elders in a God-honoring, obedient way.
圣经里面其实在告诉我们。如果你没有好好的服从和对待你的牧师和长老的话，其实对你本身也是没有益处。
Now as you're all becoming Westerners, obedience and submission is a bit foreign in a Western culture.
在座很多各位都已经要成为西方文化的一份子，你就会发现顺服与降服在今天的西方文化是非常另类的想法。
The confidence in your leaders is really about putting your trust in Jesus.
相信你的领袖就是把你的信心放在耶稣身上并且跟随他。
I often feel and discover as a pastor that when there are people who are having real difficulty with me or won't listen or whatever, it's not usually about me, it's about them and God.
作为一个牧师，我的经验是，当有些人不愿意听从我的话的时候。他们对我有意见的时候，往往不是因为我个人的问题，而是因为他们与神之间的关系出了问题。
That's not to say we're perfect.
并不是说我们做牧师是完美。
But we have elders like John Wood keeping an eye on me. Don't you?
但是我们在教会里面也有像 Grace Hill 和 John Wood 这样的长老在看顾我们这些牧师。
1 Thessalonians 2:13 is a good passage.And we also thank God continually because when you received the word of God, which you heard from us, you accepted it not as a human word, but as it actually is, the word of God, which is indeed at work in you who believe.
在《罗马家前书》2:13说到，为此我们也不住地感谢神。因为你们听见我们所传神的道就领受不以为是人的道乃以为是神的道这道实在是神的并且运行在你们信主的心中
So when one of us preachers listen to hear through imperfect vessels the word of God from God to you to your heart
我们这些传道人当然是一些不完美的器皿，但是这些不完美的器皿也可以从天上领受神的道，然后通过我们传到你身上。
The writer of Hebrews urges us to pray for our leaders because we need it a lot.
希伯来书的作者劝勉我们要为我们的领袖祷告，因为我们作为领袖非常需要我们的祷告。
And then finally, number 7.
第七点。
The writer ends up with a prayer.
这段经文以一段祷告结尾。
As it's not actually easy to be a Christian in our own strength.
因为作为基督徒，以我们自己的力量是绝对做不到的。
So two parts to the prayer.
这段祷告分为两部分。
May God equip you with everything good for doing His will.
一点，愿神在各样善事上成全你们，叫你们遵行他的旨意。
God tells us what to do and how to live as a believer and follower of Jesus.
神告诉我们，作为一名信徒和耶稣的跟随者，应该做什么，如何做。
And He does not cruelly leave us to do it on our own.
他没有让我们靠自己的能力去做，因为那样的话非常的残忍。
He gives us all that we need to be faithful Christians, followers of Jesus.
我们作为一个信实的基督徒，所一切所需的，神都赐给我们。
2 Peter 1:3, His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of Him who called us by His glory and goodness.
彼得后书1:3说道，神的神能将一切关乎生命和前进的事赐给我们，皆因我们认识那用自己荣耀和美德招我们的主。
Everything He calls us to do, He provides us with the gifts and strength that we need.
他呼召我们去做的每一件事，他都会把所需要的恩赐和力量加添给我们。
However, we do not have that strength until we step out and use it.
但是我们若非迈出信心的步伐，便不可能得到他所赐的恩典和能力。
I can spend time preparing a message.
我可以花很多的时间来预备一篇讲章。
I can read all the books.
我可以读很多的书。
I can pray.
我可以祷告。
And then pray.
然后继续祷告。
And then pray.
再祷告。
And then pray.
再祷告。
And then pray.
还是祷告。
And nothing happens.
但什么事情都不会发生。
Useless.
没有用。
No one hears anything.
没有人听到我说的任何话。
Not until I pick up the pen.
我必须要拿出我的笔。
Push the little button on the end.
然后按一下那支笔。
Put the pen on the paper.
然后把那支笔放在纸上。
And start writing.
然后开始写下我的奖章。
Then I find God gives me the words and the strength and the enablement.
在那个时候，当我开始用笔下笔写字的时候，我才能够发现神所赐给我的恩典和能力。
I want to witness to my neighbor.
我想向我的邻居做见证。
That's a good idea from God.
这是从神来的一个很好的主意。
I know what I want to say.
我知道我应该说什么。
But it's not until I go and knock on their door.
但是直到我开始去敲邻居的那扇门的时候。
It's not until I open this.
直到我开口向邻居说话的时候。
That God's power comes to enable me to speak.
神的灵才有可能从我里面出来，来赐给我能力。
Sometimes I get prompted to pray for someone.
有的时候我受感动要为某人祷告。
It's a great idea.
这是很好的一个想法。
Sometimes you go and pray for healing.
有的时候为一个人的生病得医治祷告。
But the person doesn't get healed.
但是这个人并没有得到医治。
Until I go, I have to lay hands on them. And lay hands on the person.
直到我为这个人按手祷告的时候。
And then pray.
然后再祷告。
And ask God to heal.
然后求神来医治他。
And then the power comes.
这时候神的能力才降下来。
And so God calls us to work, but until we actually step out and do what He's calling us to do, there is no power until we start to do it.
神赐下他的话语，赐下他的呼召，但除非我们迈出信心的步伐，走出这第一步，顺服他的命令，便不可能得到他所应许的恩典。
My car's got lots of power.
我的车有很多的能力。
Twin overhead cam, 2.4 liter.
油门2.5, 2.4是吧
？This wasn't the translation. Pedal sticks on the steering wheel.
就是这辆车很有能力。
And it's not until I put my foot on the accelerator.
但我如果开始加油门的话 它就是没有能力。
The same with us until we step out and do what God's telling us to do, we have His power.
我们若非迈出信心的步伐，便不可能得到从神来的能力。
And may He work in us that which is pleasing to Him through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory.
这段祷告的第二段说到，又提着耶稣基督在你们心里行他所喜悦的事，愿荣耀归
他。Not only does God give us all we need to live as Christians,
神不仅赐给我们做基督徒所需要的一切。
But God comes and lives this miracle in us so that He is actually working or achieving in us all that He asks us to do.
他也住在我们中间，住在我们里面，这样他才能真正的完成他要求我们所做的一切。
So Philippians 2:13.
就像腓立比书二章十三节。
For it is God who works in you to will and act according to His good purpose.
因为你们立志行事，都是神在你们心里运行，为要成就他的。
In Galatians 2:20, I have been crucified with Christ and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me.
我已经与基督同钉十字架，现在活着的不再是我，乃是基督在我里面活着，并且我如今在肉身活着，是因信神的儿子而活。他是爱我，为我舍己。
Christian life is an extraordinary miracle.
基督徒的生命是一个非凡的神迹。
It's not a religion.
这不是一个宗教。
It's a dynamic relationship. It's a life lived with God.
这是与神之间一种互动的、充满活力的一种互动的关系，是为主而活。
God calls us to live lives that are different to the world as we trust in Him.
神呼召我们活出与这世界完全不同的生命，那就是信靠他。
And God equips us with everything we need to live as effective Christians.
我们作为一个有果效的基督徒，一切所需的神都赐给了我们。
And God Himself works in us to achieve all that He asks us to be and to do.
神自己在我们心中动工，来成就他要求我们所做的和所事的。
As Christians, we are called to be a living miracle.
作为基督徒，我们蒙召要活出一个神迹般的人生。
Let's pray.
让我们一起。